University Watch and Creative Business with Lloyd Luna. Our next guest is a graduate of Hotel and Restaurant Administration at the University of the Philippines, Diliman. He is a freelance marketing communications and public relations consultant and dabbles in event hosting and copywriting. How is that? He spearheads all the corporate social responsibility activities of the restaurant. And by the way, he is also a board member, public relations officer of EVA, EVA Charity Foundation. Now the owner, one of the owners, I don't know, of Sugarleaf, Angelo Sonko.
Do you mind being called
Angel?
Angel is good, yeah.
Angel is
Angel,
good.
Angelo, Jello.
Angelo, Jello.
Yeah.
Most people, how did they call you?
Well, my family calls me Jello. That's my childhood name. Mm-hmm. But you know, when I started working in the corporate industry after college, my first boss, when she saw my nameplate, it said Jello, and it was spelled J-E-L-L-O. She said, people won't take you seriously. So she changed it. My real name is Jose Angelo. Uh-huh. So it became Angelo. But now that, you know, I'm an entrepreneur, uh-huh. And then, you know, of course, I control pretty much what I do. So okay. I decided to put that back in because one of the product lines of the restaurant I'm with is actually named after me, our ice cream.
Right.
So it's so called Jello. Jello's ice cream.
Like gelato or something?
Yeah, Jello.
Yeah,
pronounced Jello.
Yeah, does it have something to do with the business that you are right now? I mean, the name?
One of the product lines of Sugarleaf, which is our healthy establishment, our healthy restaurant in Green Hills, which, by the way, just opened another branch here in Makati at Urdaneta Village. We basically try to offer everything that's healthy, whether it's, you know, food or, you know, vegetables or produce, and even health and wellness workshops, which we do at least once or twice a month.
Interesting how you actually came about this kind of business.
That's right.
I mean, you have been through a lot of works after school.
Yes, yes. I took up hotel and restaurant administration, as you mentioned.
Is there a reason for that?
I really like to cook when I was younger, and you know when we were smaller.
That's
of course,
not too long ago. I mean,
no, yeah, I'm kind of old already. But
really?
Yeah, when I was
too many people admit that they do.
When I was smaller, me and my three cousins, you know, there wasn't any, you know, video games at that time, so we.
Oh, I understand. That was kind of long.
so we would play with, you know, scraps of paper. We would draw menus. We would make food out of paper and stuff like that. And then when I was growing up in high school and college, I would spend a lot of time in our family bakery, mm-hmm. in the province. It's called La Moderna. It's been around for 70 years. So I would be there usually during summer vacations. I would help out in the cashier. Mm-hmm. And every so often, I would, you know, tinker around in the kitchen. And
did you do
stuff.
It at will? Or
oh,
your
yeah,
father said, hey, work?
No, not really. You know, actually, they were kind of, sort of against it because, you know, they would prefer me to be in Manila for the summer holidays. But, you know, I was...
Oh, you must be kidding me. many family, I mean, most parents, if they're in the business, they say, okay, probably you can work.
Yeah, well, maybe because, you know, it was away from home or something. But, you know...
But you're not a headache to them, are you?
No. I was a very good boy.
Okay, you don't work in the summer, go somewhere else. No.
Yeah, that's basically where I got to appreciate, you know, cooking and baking. Even though first, before hotel school, I took up chemistry because I wanted to become a doctor.
Okay, that becomes weird when you try to cook and now you want to be a chemist.
When I was younger, yeah, because I wanted to become a doctor, so chemistry was my pre-med course.
Oh, I see.
Fortunately, just after a year and a half, three semesters, I realized I couldn't stand the sight of blood. So right then and there, I made a decision. I told my parents that I couldn't continue it. So of course there was a little bit of, you know, discussion and disappointment,
yeah.
Of course, but eventually I shifted to hotel school. I graduated pretty okay, and then eventually when I started working, I think I did a pretty good job in the hotel industry.
Yeah, and there's a freelance marketing communications and public relations. So
yeah.
I tried to connect.
Yes. Okay. Connect. After college, because in the UP, they don't basically just teach you, let's say, cooking or hotel administration. They pretty much teach you the holistic discipline of hospitality management.
Oh.
So, I mean, unlike other schools nowadays, you know, there's a lot of culinary courses that really, let's say, put you in the culinary field or in management.
Basically, that's it, no?
That's
you,
right.
You don't understand the entire team. The relations of basically what you're doing.
Administration and operation. So, anyway, when I finished college, you know, of course, I applied in different hotels.
Mm-hmm.
After my practicum, you know, I realized that I didn't want to be in operations. I didn't like standing up so long in the front desk or maybe even preparing food, even though I liked doing that at home.
Right.
So my first job actually took me to Cebu. I worked in a resort in Cebu for 3 years, mm-hmm. and that was in public relations and marketing communications.
Right.
So I guess I also like to write, even though it wasn't really formally taught in class. But that's where I got lined up in. And then so after Cebu, I went back to Manila, worked in Manila, worked in abroad.
So why leave Cebu?
Well, after 3 years, you know, I think that was enough. You know, I enjoyed myself there, learned a lot, of course. And then it was time to go back to Manila. So, I mean, I transferred to the same hotel group, but in one of their Manila properties. And then there was an opportunity for me to be promoted as a department head in another property in Pampanga. So I moved there, even though it was a smaller resort. I mean, at least I was, you know, heading up the department.
Sure.
I had four staff under me. So at least I got to learn a lot about, you know, leadership skills and stuff. Mm-hmm. And then after that, it was still a hotel. Still, all of this is under sales and marketing communications. I got a chance to go back to that previous hotel group. I went to Dubai. Mm-hmm. It was the pre-opening hotel of their of their first branch outside of the Asia Pacific region.
Right. Yeah, and then finally, after those long, very long journey stories you have there, what made you decide you want to venture into something that you can call your own?
That's right. Okay. Anyway, just 30 seconds. After I came back from Dubai, so that was all sales and marketing experience, I wanted to know more about, let's say, sales and business development, actually selling the products. So I worked in three, four companies under marketing, sales and business development. So, and then you mentioned that I got bitten by the entrepreneurial bug. Well, similar to your first guest, actually, even when I was in college, I sold toothbrushes, I sold, you know, I sold a lot of things. And in the two organizations I was with, some of our fundraising activities for the organization would be food sales.
Right.
And I'm usually the one they assign to prepare food. So anyway, so after around 4 or 5 years in sales, that's when I decided to put up my first venture into the restaurant business. Yeah. So basically, it was like a little branch of the La Moderna in Pampanga, which we brought to Manila. Mm-hmm. Me and my three cousins set it up there, and we sold pretty much the big products of our bakery in the province, because it was already pretty well known in Pampanga, because it's been there for the longest time.
So when you bring it to Manila, you probably have a greater chance, because the name is already...
That's right, yeah. Of course, there's a history behind it. And then, of course, there's a lot of people in Manila that already know about the product, because either we give it out to them, or it's given to them in some occasion.